or even people who can eat like tons and tons of carbs and be really slim. I'm not one of those people.
But her name is High Carb Hannah. Change it to Low Carb Hannah. Come on, Hannah, change the name. Coach Greg, and today I'm going to be reviewing popular YouTuber High Carb Hannah. High Carb Hannah once was 70 pounds overweight, and then she went vegan and started eating better and lost the 70 pounds and now looks fantastic. I'm gonna go over her latest video called How I Changed One Simple Thing and Lost 20 Pounds and see if it's the one thing that you should do. Is it a magic? Is it easy? Does it work? Now, I wonder if the one simple thing is if she went low carb from being High Carb Hannah. When you lose that much weight, it's very noticeable and people can relate and they want to know what to do. Now, just because she lost 70 pounds, does it mean she knows more than you? Does it mean she knows more than me? Well, we're soon going to find out. Do I agree or disagree with what she says? So, she's vegan, vegetarian. She doesn't like eating animals because she's for the animals. I have no problem with that. If you are vegan, that is perfectly cool. That's amazing. You know, I have nothing. To me, it's like this. Eat what you want. Be healthy as long as it works for you. So I'm not against any special diet. If you want to eat meat, so be it. If you don't, so be it. So there's nothing wrong with what she's doing there at all. You can build muscle as a vegan. Of course you can. So don't even worry about that. So I watched a few of her videos. One was called Eat More, Weigh Less. 300 calorie filling meals. Immediately I thought, well, she clearly knows something. Filling meals. Low calorie dense foods, they're filling. They're 300 calorie meals and they weigh a pound. So I can see that she understands that if you eat things that have less calories and you can eat a lot of it, it's going to help you lose weight because you feel more full. So she's selling her ebooks 40% off. Unlike me, I'm never putting 40% off on an ebook, that's for sure. But she says this, I like this.
That means you can get my best-selling weight loss guide, Lean and Clean, for only $17.
Now, don't get me wrong, I'm not against the book, I'm sure it's amazing. But it's her best-selling book out of the four or five, whatever, that she made. It's not literally a best-selling book. It didn't sell millions of copies. You can buy my best-selling book out of mine. I have two ebooks. My best-selling book is the cookbook, not the training book. So you can buy Coach Greg's $99 cookbook for $99 right now. It's the best-selling book. It's my best-selling book. It's not the number one best-selling book in the world. I'm sure Chef Ramsay and Martha Stewart would think, no, I don't think he sold as many as we have. Their books aren't better than mine. Of course, obviously not. Of course they're not. But I'm not here to say it's the best-selling book just because it's selling the best out of the books that I've made. So I just had to say that. I'm not against this girl, but I'm just amused when I saw that in the video. So let's get into the video. I changed one simple thing and lost 20 pounds. Let's see what she did. So like me, the majority of people who follow her channel are doing so to try and lose weight. Most people watching my channel, like you're watching this right now, you probably want to lose weight. Yeah, you probably want to build muscle too, but most people are trying to lose weight. So she has a channel to help you lose weight and she's lost 70 pounds and kept it off, so she knows what she's doing. And so let's see.
See like how people eat so differently. And I'm gonna be explaining, you know, why that is.
There are high carb, low carb, small portion, large portion. People are fat, skinny, thin, tall, whatever. It's all there. The thing is, you need to be in a calorie deficit to lose weight. We all know this. The funny thing is we don't all know this, but we should. I'm sure she's gonna point this out.
And they think like, as long as I don't eat any fat, I'm gonna lose weight. And that is a huge misconception.
And on the opposite end, there's the exact opposite group of morons that think, as long as it's fat, I can't gain weight, as long as it's low carb. And they're throwing in oil and peanut butter and nuts and fat and bacon and all kinds of high calorie dense foods, but it's low carb, so I won't gain weight. They think that it's macro management. It's not. It's calorie management. You need to be in a deficit to lose weight. You need to. You cannot break the laws of thermodynamics as much as we want to. We don't, in fact, come from Krypton. We don't have magic rules. We are not superhumans. We're not Superman. And even if we were, Superman could die. If he gets close to that freaking thing, the green stuff. If you're next to kryptonite, even Superman can't handle that. We all have a weakness. The problem is most of our weaknesses is high calorie, freaking dense foods, highly palatable foods, junk food, snacking food, you know it. The stuff that's in your pantry that shouldn't be there. Out of sight, out of mind. If you could do those simple steps, you'd lose weight. Okay? That's our kryptonite. We need to stay away from the foods that are the most tempting, that trigger us to want to keep eating.
I actually gained a lot of weight, 30 pounds, when I first came to a vegan diet, and I was eating like 3 to 4,000 calories worth of carbohydrates a day. And yeah, I gained a lot of weight.
Hello, Allie. Hi, girlfriend. That's you. You went vegan and started eating more. More pizza, more carbs, and more everything. You got to eat less calories. Just because it's not from animals or meat doesn't mean you can just eat as much of it as you want. There's a lot of carbs in vegan items. There is. Not all of them, but a lot do. You have to be careful. You can't just say, I'm vegetarian now, so now I can eat whatever I want. I'll never gain weight. It's not true. Jelly beans have a lot of freaking calories. It does. You can't just eat whatever you want just because you're vegan.
And truly, I believe that there's only really one core concept that you have to get down, and you will have no issues losing or maintaining weight for the rest of your life.
So there's one concept. One. This is it. This is the one to remember. Remember this right now. One concept to help you lose and maintain that weight for the rest of your life. Are you ready for it?
But it's just the idea of calorie density.
Calorie density. Low calorie dense foods. The amount of calories per pound. The less it is, the better. If you can stick to eating low calorie dense foods, like vegetables and fruit, you're gonna lose weight in the long run and keep it off. That's the secret. That's the end all be all. If you can incorporate more fruit and vegetables, I don't care if you think there's fructose and fructose is gonna kill you. It is not. If you eat more fruits and vegetables, it's going to replace a lot of the other higher calorie dense foods that you eat, and you will for sure freaking lose weight. You don't even need to count your calories. Don't need to track it, because you're going to eat low calorie dense foods that make you full. Think of it, a pound of it, she had recipes under 300 calories for a pound. Eat 5 pounds of it, that's only 1,500 calories in the day. Not many people are getting obese by eating 1,500 calories. 5 pounds. It's a lot of friggin' food. It's a lot. Try eating 5 pounds. Sit there and eat 5 pounds. It's a lot. Make a 5-pound salad and see if you finish it. You're probably not going to finish it. So this is the secret. Low calorie dense foods, fruit and vegetables. That's the secret. That's going to help you for sure. What is another secret? Buy my friggin' cookbook. That's what I base my diets on. Low calorie dense food eating. It doesn't all have to be fruit and vegetables. What if I don't like fruit and vegetables? It's gross. I don't want to eat that. Well, guess what? I got delicious, low-calorie, dense foods that are not just fruits and vegetables that you can eat, like protein ice cream. And the list goes on and on, and I'm not going to spend the entire video promoting a cookbook. You already know you need to buy it, so just buy it.
And I feel like the easiest way for people to implement this is to just eat more vegetables.
We're 4 minutes into the video. It's a 30-minute video, and I feel like it should be done. Like, what more is there? What is she gonna say? It's done. So she posts up pictures. You can see less ripped, more ripped, smaller waist, lost some good amount of weight, pulled up the bikini higher to hide the scarring or dents, and is a more flattering pose, the hips twisted. So yeah, of course she's exaggerating the after photo. Everyone exaggerates the after photo. The before, it's like, yeah. And the after, it's like, ooh, twisting and making it look better. Everybody does that.
I lost 20 pounds just implementing eating half of each of my bowls of food as vegetables. And that's it. That's all that I've done.
This is why the video keeps going, because there's some good stuff. Half of each meal is the vegetables, and the other half is whatever she's gonna eat. If you were to do that, you would lose weight. I know you would. because you're going to be more full from those vegetables. So whenever people say, oh, there's the hunger, eat some vegetables, eat some low calorie dense foods. Don't just eat the normal meal, add some of the low calorie stuff. Add 1 pound of spinach to each meal. That's 100 calories. You're not even going to be able to eat that. So much easier to eat 2 burgers. Say they're 800 calories each. Easier to eat 800 calories and another 800 than to eat 800 and 100 calories in a salad. It's easier. And the 800 plus 100 is 900. That's less than 1600, those of you not math inclined. That's a 700 calorie savings. That's a lot.
I talk about this extensively in my Lean and Clean guide. If you guys have that, you can refer to it.
If you're vegan, get the book. Can't hurt. Can't have too many books. You can get my book and get her book. What's wrong with 2 books? 2 books is better than 1 book. Pick the 5 recipes from hers and the 5 from mine, and you got 10 recipes to your repertoire of low-calorie dense foods. You will lose weight. She even said, I didn't have to cut out all my other foods. It's half of the low-calorie stuff, the other half the stuff I want, and I'm happy and I lost 20 pounds. I didn't exercise more. I didn't do anything else. It works. It will work. I eat less of the shit food and I eat... See, what I do with my cookbook is I take the shit food that you don't really want to eat, the high calorie dense stuff, and I make it lower calorie and still taste good. So you can eat your shit and eat it too. Does that make sense? You can eat your cake and eat it too. Now you can make your cake and still eat it because it's got less calories and more protein. That reminds me, I gotta make a cake with low calories with protein. I've done so in the past. Most of my foods are not, I don't put most, my cookbook, it's mostly like really, really healthy, like really low fat, really low calorie with lots of protein. So most of that's what it is. Not a lot of like average dessert. Like some people make desserts and they're low fat or low cal, but the dessert's still bad for you. It's still not good. It's still too calorie dense. Oh, you changed it from oil to coconut oil. Oh, well, that's great. It's got the same calories. It's not just if it's a healthier oil, it has to have less calories. Things like it's got a whole egg, now it's got the egg whites because it's got less calories. That's the kind of stuff you need to think about.
I haven't done anything differently. I've just eaten half of each of my plate as vegetables.
So she says she never ever feels hungry. She doesn't have to calculate calories. But she's eating vegetables, half of it, the entire plate, every single meal. It's like, that might get old. You don't need to actually go to that extreme. You don't. It's good for most of the time, but you don't need to always do that. I preach moderation. I'm not going to say to the extreme, it's all low calorie, always everything, vegetables, every meal. Nope. For my French toast with fruit, I didn't have any vegetables for breakfast. I don't eat vegetables at every meal. My protein shake's not gonna have vegetables. I don't need to throw that in there. But I do eat a lot of vegetables, for sure way more than her. But it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter how it makes you feel.
You don't need to. Just having a couple meals a day that have the vegetables or a couple low calorie dense foods compared to what you're doing now. Just a few extra is going to make the change. It's going to make the difference. You don't need to completely change your diet. You can still eat what you like. You can still eat what you love. But you're going to have some changes, and some changes all you need. If you over diet and get too lean, hunger is going to kick in. Ghrelin punches you in the face. You know it does. It's going to make you eat. Okay? But she's making great points. Low calorie dense foods. She knows what she's talking about. She used to be obese and now she's not. So she knows what she's doing. It's working. Okay, she's not spreading misinformation. She's not spreading lies. She's not spewing lies. So I recommend follow the channel, especially if you're vegan and you're looking for vegan type recipe options and ideas. Check her out. She's lost weight. You can get some ideas from her. Low calorie dense foods. That's the way to go. Not the keto and not these stupid fad diets. This ain't no fad. This is not an ad for a bad fad diet. Subscribe, click the bell button. GregDucette.com for coaching. Greg Doucette, IFBB Pro. Be sure to check out the cookbook, purchase that on my website. And until next time, I am out.